वेलकम टू myorangeslate.com फ्रॉम फ्यूचरिज्म। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल सी अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, दैट इज पैराग्राफ कंप्लीशन। दीज आर द मोस्ट कंटेम्पररी टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस सीन मोर फ्रीक्वेंटली इन लेटर ईयर्स देन से परहैप्स जंबल पैराग्राफ और पैराग्राफ समरी क्वेश्चंस। इन दीज क्वेश्चंस यू आर गिवन अ पैराग्राफ with the last sentence deleted, and this last sentence appears as one of the options, and your job is to identify this particular sentence, that is the sentence that best completes the paragraph. This type of questions, they seek to test students' ability to understand the purpose of the author. Now frequently the last sentence serves the purpose of the author, and preceding part of the passage only builds up the context, and that is why the last sentence is very important, and we have to identify accordingly whether one serves the purpose or not. Decipher the flow of reasoning and of idea. Last sentence must go along with the reasoning of the passage or the idea of the passage, and it should nail the idea home. Should match the parallel expressions in the paragraph. What I mean by parallel expressions, that we'll see with the help of couple of examples. Identify the climactic order if present, that is from the most important idea to the least important idea, or from the least important to most important. If there is a climactic order, the last sentence must follow it. Analyze the flow of writing, the style of writing, and last sentence must always match the style of writing of the author. Evaluate the necessity of the last sentence for the paragraph. Frequently, as in case of purpose of the author, the last sentence may have its own purpose to serve, say for example, emphasizing some underlying fact of the passage. Thus the last sentence, depending on the nature of the paragraph and the nature of the sentence, it may relate to the first sentence of the passage or the penultimate sentence of the passage. And that is what we have to identify and answer accordingly. Judge the impact of the last sentence on the reader. Often, authors use the last sentence to create a lasting impact on the reader's mind. And that is the purpose that must be served by the last sentence. While identifying the last sentence, we have to use one or more of these ideas. Friends, we'll see the types of paragraphs. The given paragraph may be a part of a larger writing, and in that case, it may be the introductory paragraph, or a paragraph from the body text, or the concluding paragraph. If it is introductory paragraph, then it should contain a hypothesis. And in that case, last sentence of the paragraph should give idea of what is to follow. So, it should give a hook to the subsequent paragraph. If the given paragraph is one from the body text, the first sentence of the paragraph must give reverse hook to the preceding paragraph. That is, it must relate to the preceding paragraph, whereas the last sentence of the paragraph should provide hook to the paragraph that follows. So, it should give us some idea regarding what is to follow now. Right, friends? So the first sentence gives us reverse hook, whereas the last sentence gives us a hook to the following paragraph. If the paragraph is concluding paragraph, in that case it should summarize the idea, present the hypothesis in no uncertain terms. That is, the last sentence should nail the idea home, so it must have the punch or the impact. But more frequently, friends, the paragraphs that appear in CAT exam are not part of larger writings. They are the complete writing in themselves. There is most questions fall in this category of paragraphs where author has written only so much to convey his or her ideas. Now, if an author writes just 150 to 200 words on an idea, it would mean that author would require greater mental space than what it takes to read the short paragraph. So, author needs to present the idea in such a way that reader keeps thinking at least for a while after reading the passage. And to serve this purpose, the last sentence should be a strong punchline. It must have a strong message, or it must be a cryptic sentence which is not readily understood. Right, friends? Here, you need to evaluate the necessity and impact of the last sentence. And remember, most of the questions would fall in this category. We also need to keep in mind that author needs to complete the idea he/she is presenting. So, within the paragraph, the idea should reach its logical conclusion. And this particular aspect refers to the purpose of the author, that why the author writes a particular passage, what is the idea that he or she wishes to convey. And to fulfill this purpose, the last sentence may continue from the penultimate sentence or refer to the penultimate sentence, or it may refer to the introducing sentence. Now, say for example, if author presents a theory and then explains the theory in subsequent discussion, the last sentence has to refer to the theory, and so it may refer to the first sentence, and particularly if author takes a few examples in between. Right, friends? Let us see a few questions. Though not on CAT format, but then would still serve us well. In the following paragraph, find the sentence which destroys the unity of the passage. Friends, pause the video and read this passage and identify the sentence which destroys unity. Yes, friends. Continuing the discussion, if we see, this passage is about tourism's effect on developing countries. Now, while the first sentence talks about tourism's effect on local people, particularly in developing countries, although the buildings and etc. create jobs, they are usually low paid. Hotels in particular fail to provide tourists with a life similar to that they would expect at home. Now, this particular sentence talks about the tourists. It does not talk about the local people, or it does not talk about the developing countries. Local customs are often exploited for the tourists' benefits. In Guatemala, for example, women who make the brightly colored clothes favored by tourists have begun using designs and colors that they feel will appeal more to foreigners. And that is how the local customs are exploited or compromised upon. Hence, these two sentences go in continuity. It is a statement 3 which talks about tourists, which destroys the unity of the passage. Thus, the answer is option C. Is that clear, friends? We'll see another question. Now, here you need to identify a sentence which can fit into the blank given in the passage. Dioxin, a man-made substance used in different forms of pesticides, is perhaps the most deadly toxic chemical known today. When the substance is used even at extremely low levels, it has devastating effects on laboratory animals. Some incidences of cancer, miscarriage, and birth defects, for instance, have been attributed to inhaling this toxic substance. So, friends, here, if we analyze this passage, the first sentence talks about dioxin being most deadly toxic chemical. And then it discusses the harmful effects of dioxin. Now, if you see here, the sentence before the blank talks about effect of dioxin on laboratory animals. The sentence that follows the blank talks about the diseases which are attributed to inhaling this toxic substance. So, the sentence in the blank must follow the pattern and relate to either the preceding one or the one that follows, or should give some other effect. Let us see. Some animals seem to have developed resistance to dioxin. Though, it talks about resistance to dioxin and hence it cannot fit into the passage. Governments in many countries have banned the use of dioxin in experiments. Now, even this sentence cannot fit into the passage since it talks about a particular example that is given here, and there is no connector with which this sentence starts. say therefore, hence, or there's the reason, something like that. In practice, dioxin is also being used in insecticides. Now, the usage of dioxin should have gone well with different forms of pesticides here. Furthermore, the consequences of the presence of dioxin in the air have been obvious. Now, presence of dioxin in the air. The sentence that follows talks about the diseases which are attributed to inhaling this toxic substance. So this sentence is more appropriate than any other that we have read so far. The use of pesticides in agriculture has been limited despite the increase in crop yields. Once again, is not in the context of the passage, and hence we know that option D has to be the correct answer. Is that clear, friends? Inhaling gives us the idea that dioxin in air is the correct answer. Let us now see a little different type of questions. Once again, unlike CAT questions. Now here is a passage given with four blanks and you have five statements. You need to identify one statement for each blank. Please pause the video, and since there is a lot of text on this particular slide, you should view this in full screen mode and answer this question. As an alternative, if you have the book, you can open the book. There too, I mean, you have this passage, though even longer one and with more sentences. Continuing the discussion, the first sentence after the blank talks about Bill Gates being the richest man in America. So the introducing sentence has to do something with wealth or something with earning. Above all, he is a technical whiz kid, does not fit in. It's a hard life competing against the new technicians, would not fit in. Of course, that wealth. So wealth should have been mentioned prior to this particular sentence. Gates started early. There is no mention of his starting early in the first passage. So how do you become a billionaire? Now that has to be the first sentence. Bill Gates, the head of Microsoft, the creator of basic MS-DOS, Windows and Flight Simulator, is the richest man in America. And something similar. If you live to be 70, you would have to make $100 million every year of your life in order to come up with what Gates is currently worth. After this, obviously the statement C, because that wealth. Of course, that wealth is largely the result of Microsoft's astronomical share price. Gates himself draws a salary around $3 lakh and something on so on. He is a one-man band. He works 15-hour days and loses his temper easily. He is addicted to competition and to winning. He enjoys poker and fast cars. Above all, he is a technical whiz kid. So this is the third sentence. Of course, this was the second. By the time he was 16, he had already set up a company. So this gives us the idea that this has to fit into the fourth blank. Is that clear, friends? Let us see another similar question. Once again, I would advise you that you pause the video and read this in full screen mode and answer these questions. And once again, if you have the book, you can open that. It would be easier reading through the book than video screen. Continuing the discussion, friends, in the first blank, what should we have? It has moved into legitimate companies which provide a perfect mechanism for laundering illegal funds. The statement G, because it here refers to big crime. Because subsequent sentence also continues in the same way, it owns and it also controls. Right, friends? If we see the second blank, we must have sentence D. That is, but he has moved. So he pronoun here continues with the preceding sentence. He made millions of rubles by running underground textile factories, etc. And in the third sentence, we must have the statement C. Because the preceding sentence once again talks about the outer door is reinforced with double metal plates inside and some. Is that clear, friends? Now let us see a couple of questions on CAT format where the last sentence is deleted and you need to identify one from the option choices which fits in the last sentence the best. Once again, pause the video and read this in full screen mode. Analyzing this passage, it starts with assorted automobile companies tempting customers with finances at the rates of interest significantly lower than cost of money. And then it provides the rationale for lower rates of interest. And he gives the reasons thereof and completes this particular discussion. So it makes sense for the companies to offer subsidized financing to boost sagging sales. So here is where he completes the discussion of lower rates of interest on financing offers by automobile companies. Then he continues to discuss, but the interesting part is the impact on the companies of bearing the burden of interest subsidy. The more successful companies would innovate yet more ways to pare their costs down further. So friends, here he starts a different discussion. So the last sentence has to continue with this discussion and not with the preceding discussion. Let us see the options. Higher interest rates that drive down car sales via more expensive car loans would ultimately spawn a series of business innovations that would make the industry more competitive. Now this is something which is just repetition of the idea presented in preceding sentence. That is in the penultimate sentence. The more successful companies would innovate yet more ways. If you read the next option, it makes sense to realize that higher rates of interest help to channel investment away from sectors with low returns. Now, this is out of the context because the passage does not talk about channeling of the investments or the sectors. This is, of course, one example of how the market is supposed to work to deliver socially benign outcomes. Now, once again, out of the context option, because within so much part, author would not discuss three ideas, right? The interest rates, the innovations, and then finally socially benign outcomes. These innovations could be on the shop floor, in the choice of materials, sourcing of components, technological change, or modes of financing. Now this relates to the penultimate sentence, which talks about innovations, and this very well completes the passage. All such new efforts would be missing in a regime that provides subsidized credit. Now this again is irrelevant sentence here. So friends, the answer is option 4. And what makes it the correct answer? With so it makes sense, the author completes the discussion on interest and introduces a new idea that more successful companies would innovate yet more. Now the option 1 is repetition of the same idea. Option 2 talks about sectors, a completely newer idea which author normally would not present in the last sentence. Same is the case with socially benign outcomes, and missing makes it irrelevant. These innovations actually refers to what is mentioned in the penultimate sentence, and hence the option 4 has to be the correct answer. Right friends, let us see another question on the same format. Friends, if we analyze this paragraph, it starts with an example about physics journals. Now author gives this example to make the point that exponential growth is fallacious and absurd. That this absurdity is an example of what one might call the exponential growth fallacy. Then author gives two more examples from technology, one regarding the moon landing and other regarding the robotics. The moon landing example ends here and the robotic example starts here. Friends, if we analyze this paragraph, we see that author starts with an example about physics journals. Then he provides two more examples, one about the moon landing and other about the robotics. If we remove these examples from the passage, we are left with only one sentence, and that is, this absurdity is an example of what one might call the exponential growth fallacy. So with this particular sentence, author gives the idea that exponential growth is fallacious and absurd. Now, if you look at the options, the key point about exponential growth is that it never lasts. Now, given the style of writing, author has already said that exponential growth is a fallacious idea. So this statement, as the last statement, does not qualify because it's just repeating the idea. In the event these technologies became stuck or even slid backwards. Now, when author gives this particular idea, when author uses the example of physics journals, he does not say anything about the example once the example is done with. When the author gives the example of physics journals, he does not comment upon the example. So if author gives examples of technology, he would not comment upon the example again. So that is the parallel structure of expression that author maintains here. That he gives the example and leaves it to reader to make his or her own conclusions. He just states that library bookshelves would have to expand at the speed of light to accommodate them. Or he simply says that moon landing was the first small step to escalator to the stars, and Arthur C. Clarke predicting huge lunar bases and a Jupiter expedition by 2001. But he doesn't comment upon that this didn't happen. The rapid uptake of robotics led to the prediction of cyborg servants and android armies within a few decades. Once again, author would not comment upon this. And hence, option 2 is incorrect or unlikely to be the last sentence. The conditions for runaway expansion are always peculiar and temporary. Well, when author already says that the runaway expansion or exponential growth is fallacious, this sentence is again a redundant sentence and would not qualify to be the last sentence. The next option, if we see, it says that, but this sobering fact has not stopped futurologist and author Ray Kurzweil from invoking exponential or even hyper-exponential growth in the realm of IT. This possibly would qualify for the last sentence, because if you look at the purpose of the author definitely does not just want to give examples. He is leading us to some idea that exponential growth, whenever thought of, has proved to be fallacious. And this particular sentence gives us that purpose of the author, that he is invoking this idea of exponential growth fallacy in case of Ray Kurzweil's expectation in the realm of IT. As we can see, cyborg servants and android armies are still a far cry from reality. Once again, author is not commenting on any of the examples and hence would not comment on android armies and cyborg servants either. Is that clear, friends? Once again, if we see, author presents the idea of exponential growth being fallacious by mentioning three examples, that library bookshelves will have to expand at the speed of light, Arthur C. Clarke predicting huge lunar bases and Jupiter expedition, and predictions of cyborg servants and android armies. Now, never lasts, and these technologies. These words make these sentences unqualified, peculiar and temporary, and similarly cyborg servants and android armies. We can get to the answer by thinking about the purpose of the author. That which of these sentences would serve the purpose of the author, if there is any. And that is statement 4, because that helps us identify the purpose of the author as well. That author is presenting these ideas in order to prove that wherever exponential growth has been invoked, it has proved to be fallacious. Is that clear, friends? Thus we know that correct answer is option 4. Now, friends, let us see a few CAT questions. This question appeared in CAT 2005. Once again, pause the video and answer this question before we discuss this. If you analyze this passage, friends, the author writes that The audiences for crosswords and Sudoku understandably overlap greatly, but there are differences too. A crossword attracts a more literary person, while Sudoku appeals to a keenly logical mind. Now friends, it's up to here that author discusses crossword and Sudoku rather indifferently or impartially. From here on, if we see, some crossword enthusiasts turn up their noses at Sudoku because they feel it lacks depth. A good crossword requires vocabulary, knowledge, mental flexibility, and sometimes even a sense of humor to complete. It touches numerous areas of life and provides an aha or two along the way. So friends, here on if we see, the ideas are presented from the perspective of crossword enthusiasts. And they seem to be pretty partial about it, isn't that? Now if we see, Sudoku on the other hand is just a logical exercise, each one similar to the last. Now, this sentence contrasts with versatility that crossword requires and offers, and aha or two along the way. It very well contrasts with this and can be the last sentence because it has to go with crossword enthusiast's perspective. Sudoku, incidentally, is growing faster in popularity than crosswords, even among the literati. Now, this cannot be the answer, because from crossword enthusiast's perspective, this is not the correct idea. Sudoku, on the other hand, can be attempted and enjoyed even by children. This again does not fit to be the last sentence. Sudoku, however, is not exciting in any sense of the term. Now, this can be the last sentence. But then it just addresses the idea of aha or two. It does not address the idea of crossword requiring vocabulary, knowledge, mental flexibility, and even a sense of humor. Whereas the sentence one addresses both the ideas. That is just a logical exercise and each one similar to the last. And hence, friends, the correct answer is option one. I say, from here on, the idea changes. This is what author has to say, and this is what crossword enthusiast has to say from here on. It touches numerous areas of life and provides an aha or two. And contrasting this from the perspective of crossword enthusiasts, the option one is the correct answer. We'll see another CAT question. Once again, pause the video and answer this question before I start discussing this question. If you analyze this paragraph, it says that most firms consider expert individuals to be too elitist, temperamental, egocentric, and difficult to work with. Force such people to collaborate on a high-stakes project and they might just come to fisticuffs. Even the very notion of managing such a group seems unimaginable. So what it says is, expert individuals are elitist, temperamental, and difficult to work with. If they have to collaborate, they might come to fisticuffs. Even the very notion of managing such a group seems unimaginable. So most organizations fall into the default mode, setting up project teams of people who get along nicely. So in this passage, author contrasts expert individuals with people who get along nicely. Thus, he implicitly says that people who get along nicely are not expert individuals. Because if they were expert individuals, they would be difficult to work with. Now, considering this contrast and this implied idea, if we look at the options, the result, however, is disastrous. Let us see. This may just be the answer. The result is mediocrity. These two can be the answer though. Result is creation of experts who then become elitist. Now this cannot be the answer. Because what author is trying here is contrast expert individuals with people who get along nicely. Author definitely would not introduce an idea of creating experts in the last sentence. That does not serve the purpose of the author. Naturally, they drive innovations. Obviously not, because people who get along nicely are not expert individuals. So now, friends, we are left with these two options. Now, whether the result would be disastrous or mediocrity, that remains to be seen. But what author implies is, people who get along nicely are not expert individuals. Author does not imply here that they would be inefficient or ineffective. So it means that disaster is uncalled for, disastrous word is uncalled for. Answer has to be the result is mediocrity. Also, friends, when result is mediocrity, if this is the last sentence, the reader is kept thinking for a while on this passage. And that is where this becomes more appropriate sentence too. Expert individuals are elitist, temperamental, egocentric, and difficult to work with. They might just come to fisticuffs. Teams of people who get along nicely. So people who get along nicely are supposedly not expert individuals. Disastrous is not suggested by the author. If you see, people get along well and hence do not qualify to be elitist according to the author. And since people who get along well are not expert individuals, would they drive innovations? Thus, friends, we know that answer has to be the option 2. We'll see another question. Once again, answer this question before we discuss. If you see this passage, Federer's fifth Grand Slam win prompted a reporter to ask whether he was the best ever. Federer is certainly not lacking in confidence, but he wasn't about to proclaim himself the best ever. The best player of his generation? Yes, he said. But nowhere close to ever. Just look at the records that some guys have. I am a minnow. Now, friends, when we read this part, we are almost convinced that Federer is a minnow against people of older generations. And author would not leave us with that impression. Author would not leave reader with that impression that Federer is a minnow. Let us see. His win against Agassi, a genius from the previous generation, contradicts that. Now, a genius from the previous generation, does it give credit enough to Federer defeat a genius from the previous generation when he is on the waning part of his career? Sampras, the king of an earlier generation, was as humble. This talks more about humility of Sampras than of Federer. He is more than a minnow to his contemporaries. This produces the effect that he is not a minnow. The difference between the best of this generation and the best ever is a matter of perception. Now, once again, author would not leave it to the perception. Author has to insist and emphasize that Federer is not a minnow. Because it starts with author's winning fifth Grand Slam prompting a reporter to ask whether he was best ever. Author has to pay a tribute to Federer, and hence the option 3 is the correct answer. Not lacking in confidence to proclaim himself and his words that I am a minnow gives us the idea that he is more than a minnow to his contemporaries must be the correct answer. Let's see another question on CAT. If you analyze the passage, what it says is, does the end of knowledge and the closing of the frontier that it symbolizes is not a looming crisis at all, but merely one of many embarrassing feats of hubris in civilization's long industry. In the end, it will pass away and be forgotten. Ours is not the first generation to struggle to understand the organizational laws of frontier, deceive itself that it has succeeded, and go to its grave having failed. So author already says that many generations prior to us have struggled to understand the organizational laws of frontier, and us is not going to be the first generation to deceive itself that it has succeeded and that to go to its grave having failed. Thus author suggests that we too are deceiving ourselves and we would go to grave having failed only. And this understanding eliminates 3 of the 4 options. If you see the last one, however, this time the success is not illusory. author actually contradicts this fact and says that it is as illusory this time as it has always been. But we might be the first generation to deal with the crisis. Once again, not the correct answer. But we might be the first generation to actually reach the frontier. Once again, not the correct answer. One would be wise to be humble. This is the last sentence. This is the correct answer. Because it makes us think and it makes us accept the fact that ours is not the first generation to struggle. And we too are deceiving ourselves that we are succeeding and we too would go to grave having failed. And hence the correct answer is once again option 1. Let us see once again. Merely one of many embarrassing feats, ours is not the first generation to deceive itself that it has succeeded and go to its grave having failed. Now this is the idea that is contradicted by these three facts, by these three options, with the words actually reach, deal with the crisis and not illusory. And that helps us eliminate these three options, and the correct answer is option 1. Let us see one last question on CAT. Once again, pause the video and answer this question before I discuss it. Yes, friends, if you see, I am sometimes attacked for imposing rules. Nothing could be farther from the truth. I hate rules. All I do is report on how consumers react to different stimuli. I may say to a copywriter, research shows that commercials with celebrities are below average in persuading people to buy products. Are you sure you want to use celebrity? Now, outside the quotation, he says, call that a rule. Or I may say to an art director, research suggests that if you set the copy in black type on a white background, more people will read it than if you set it in white type on a black background. Now friends, if you see here, once again we'll reflect on parallel construction of the expressions. Author presents an idea and then comments that I hate rules. He presents an example here and then asks us, call that a rule? He presents another example here. And you must comment on this particular example once again. And that gives us option 3 as the correct answer. Because it comments on the example by suggesting that it's just a suggestion, not a rule. Guidance based on applied research can hardly qualify as rules. Now, author is not into defining rules. He's just piqued by the fact that people feel that he imposes rules. Thus, all my so-called rules are rooted in applied research. He's not accepting only that he is imposing rules. So he would not actually explain that these rules are rooted in applied research. Such principles are unavoidable if one wants to be systematic about consumer behavior. Now, principles are the rules only. And once again, author is not accepting that he is imposing rules. Fundamentally, it is about consumer behavior, not about celebrities or typesetting. Once again, it is out of the context and hence not the correct answer. We know that correct answer has to be 3 because it perfectly matches the parallel expression which author has used in the passage. Is that clear, friends? Once again, if you see, I hate rules, call that a rule. So there has to be a short sentence commenting upon the previous example that author has mentioned here. And that has to be a suggestion perhaps, but scarcely a rule. That is a parallel expression. The first option is very obvious and that is not what author is trying to say. Even second, he doesn't need to say that. The fourth sentence looks very lame and bland sentence. Completely tasteless, whereas the last option is quite irrelevant option. Friends, in subsequent session, we'll continue discussing more questions from CAT on this particular format. in the last 5 to 6 years, these type of questions have been more consistent than any other type of questions, barring reading comprehension, of course. And that's why we'll see more questions in second session and see how best we can arrive at the correct answer. For now, we'll see the trivia. When writing your essays, I encourage you to think for yourselves while you express what I had most agree with. Thank you, friends.